In this video, we will discuss and learn the sterilization. Sterilization is a process of killing microorganisms. It is useful in many of the fields like the pharma field and medical field to make the object, products, rooms, floors free from microorganisms. The outline of the video. After watching this video, you will be able to learn different terms related to sterilization, methods of sterilization. What is sterilization? Sterilization describes a process that destroys or eliminates all forms of microbial life and is carried out in healthcare facilities by physical or chemical methods. The another term which is related to killing to the microorganism is disinfection. Disinfection describes a process that eliminates many or all pathogenic microorganisms except bacterial spores on inanimate objects. The next term is cleaning. Cleaning is a simply removal of visible soil, for example organic and inorganic material, from objects and surfaces. It is normally accomplished manually or mechanically using water with detergents or enzymatic products. The next term is decontamination. Decontamination removes pathogenic microorganisms from objects so they are safe to handle, use or discard. The next term is sanitization. Sanitization is a process of disinfection, including cleansing action. Sanitizers are normally applied to inanimate objects. The next term is antiseptic. Antiseptics are the substances which prevent the sepsis, either by killing microorganism or by inhibiting the growth of microorganism. Antiseptics can be applied to body tissue. The next term is germicide. A germicide is an agent that kills vegetative cells but not necessarily the resistant spores from the germs. Then the next term is microbiostasis. Microbiostasis is a process of preventing the growth, reproduction and multiplication of microorganisms but not of killing them. So we just stop the growth, reproduction and multiplication of microorganisms, but we do not kill microorganisms in microbiostasis. The next term is preservative. A preservative is a substance that prevents the growth of microorganism. These substances are mainly added in food and pharmaceuticals to prevent microbial growth. Preservatives are not harmful to living tissues. So these are all terms which are related with the microbial growth or to make the free from microorganisms. Simultaneously, these are also the important terms when we study the sterilization. The methods of sterilization. By using different methods, we achieve the sterilization or we make the object free from microorganisms. Which are those methods? The first one is physical method. In physical method, dry heat sterilization, moist heat sterilization, radiation, or we can call it as a cold sterilization, filtration, or we can call it as a mechanical methods of sterilization. Then the second category is chemical methods, in which we sterilize by using gases. We call it as a gaseous sterilization. And the next is by using disinfectant. So these are the methods of sterilization. Mainly there are two methods, physical methods and chemical methods, and these are further classified as dry heat, moist heat, radiation, filtration, and chemical methods are again classified as gaseous sterilization and by using disinfectant. let's see one by one. Starting with the dry crystallization, sunlight. We can use sunlight for sterilization. The microbicidal activity of sunlight is mainly due to the presence of UV rays in it. It is responsible for spontaneous sterilization in natural conditions. In tropical countries, the sunlight is more effective in killing germs due to combination of UV rays and heat. By killing bacteria suspended in water, sunlight provides natural method of disinfection of water bodies such as tanks and lakes. Sunlight is not a sporicidal, hence it does not sterilize. Sunlight is a natural source of heat and UV rays, so it acts as a natural method of disinfection for water bodies such as tanks and lakes. But sunlight does not kill the spores of microorganism, hence it is not sporicidal. It is not 100% sterilizes the tank and lakes. Then red heat. Articles such as bacteriological loops, straight wires, tips of forceps and shearing spatulas are sterilized by holding them in Bunsen flame till they become red hot. This is a simple method of effective sterilization of such articles, but is limited to those articles that can be heated to redness in film. You can see in picture how the Bunsen burner and how the forceps or the nichrome wire loop is held above the Bunsen burner and sterilized till the forceps and nichrome wire loop get red. You can see in picture. The next is flaming. This is a method of passing the article over a Bunsen flame but not heating it to redness. Just we have to pass over a flame, not hold continuously on the flame. Articles such as scalpels, mouth of the test tube, flasks, glass slides and cover slips are passed through the flame for a few times. Even though most vegetative cells are killed, there is no guarantee that spores too would die on such a short exposure. This method is limited to those articles that can be exposed to flame. Cracking of the glassware may occur. This is the disadvantage of flaming, the cracking of glassware may occur. You can see how the flaming can be done. Suppose this is the test tube, when we have just passed mouth of test tube over the burner like this way, but do not hold it continuously on the flame. This is about the flaming. Then incineration. This is a method of destroying contaminated material by burning them in incinerator. Articles such as soil dressings, pathological material and bedding etc. should be subjected to incineration. This technique results in the loss of article, hence is suitable only for those articles that have to be dispose. Burning of polystyrene material emits dense smoke and hence they should not be incinerated. Then the next is hot air oven. It is widely used in many laboratories for the sterilization purpose of glassware, metals, etc. Let's see what happened in hot air oven. This method was introduced by Louis Pasteur. Articles to be sterilized are exposed to high temperature, that is 160 degrees Celsius for duration of 1 hour in an electrically heated oven. Since air is poor conductor of heat, even distribution of heat throughout the chamber is achieved by a fan. The heat is transferred to the article by radiation, conduction and convection. These three are the modes of heat transfer: radiation, conduction and convection. In hot air oven, the heat is transferred by to the article or to the subject by the means of three modes, that is radiation, conduction and convection. The oven should be fitted with a thermostat control, temperature indicator, mesh shelves, and must have adequate insulation. You can see in picture how the typical oven is look like. This is the oven where you can sterilize by using the heat transfer by convection, conduction and radiation to the object or to the article. Temperature and time relationship for hot air oven is, you can see in first column there is a temperature in degree Celsius, and in second column there is a time in minutes. For 180 degree Celsius temperature, the time is 20 minutes. For 170 degree Celsius temperature, the time is 60 minutes. For 160 degree Celsius, time is 120 minutes. For 150 degree Celsius, time is 150 minutes. And for 140 degree Celsius, time is 180 minutes. So this is the time and temperature relationship for hot air oven. The hot air oven must not be open until the temperature inside has fallen below 60 degree Celsius to prevent breakage of glassware. So this care must be taken while operating or while sterilizing the object articles, glass articles, glass object in the hot air oven. Next is moist heat sterilization. Moist heat sterilization means killing of microorganism with hot water or steam. The lethal effect of moist heat is due to the denaturation and coagulation of proteins. Moist heat sterilization is divided into three forms, that is, first is temperature below 100 degree Celsius, second is temperature at 100 degree Celsius, and third is temperature above 100 degree Celsius. The name moist heat means we are using a water vapor or water steam in the process of sterilization at temperature 100, below 100 and above 100 degree Celsius. And the killing of microorganism via moist heat occur because of denaturation and coagulation of the proteins. The first is temperature below 100 degree Celsius. Heat labile fluids may be disinfected by heating at temperature below 100 degree Celsius. The temperature employed is either 60 degree Celsius for 30 minutes, and this method is called as holder method, or 72 degree Celsius for 20 seconds, followed by rapid cooling to 30 degree Celsius or lower. This method is known as pasteurization and is widely applied in dairy products like milk and butter. By this method, non-sporing microorganisms such as mycobacteria, brucella and salmonella are destroyed. Then the second is temperature at 100 degree Celsius. Boiling of water at 100 degree Celsius kills most vegetative bacteria and viruses immediately. Certain bacterial toxins such as Staphylococcus enterotoxin are also heat resistant. Some bacterial spores are resistant to boiling and survive. Hence, this is not a substitute for sterilization. The killing activity can be enhanced by addition of 2% sodium bicarbonate. When absolute sterility is not required, certain metal articles and glassware can be disinfected by placing them in boiling water for 10 to 20 minutes. Steaming. Instead of keeping the articles in boiling water, they are subjected to free steam at 100 degrees Celsius. An autoclave with discharge tap open can also serve the same purpose. The steam that is generated sterilizes the articles when exposed to a period of 90 minutes. Media such as TCBS, DCA, and selenite broth are sterilized by steaming. Then temperature above 100 degrees Celsius. Sterilization can effectively achieve at temperature above 100 degrees Celsius using an autoclave. Water boils at 100 degrees Celsius as the atmospheric pressure, but if pressure is raised, the temperature at which the water boils also increases. As the pressure rises, the boiling point of water also rises. It has more penetrative power than dry hair. It moistens the spores. Moisture is essential for coagulation of proteins. The steam has a more penetration power than the dry air. So because of that, the resulting sterilization is good as compared to the dry heat sterilization in moisture sterilization, where the coagulation of protein is occur. You can see in picture the autoclave. The red one is a large scale autoclave. It is generally used in industries, and the stainless steel one is generally used in small laboratories. Then the next is radiation, or we can call it as a sterilization. Let's see what is radiation and cold sterilization. Two types of radiation are used. The one is ionizing and the second is non-ionizing radiation. Non-ionizing rays are low energy rays with poor penetrative power, while ionizing rays are high energy rays with good penetrative power. Since radiation does not generate heat, it is termed cold sterilization. Now you can understand why radiation is called as a cold sterilization, because the process of radiation does not generate the heat. Non-ionizing rays, rays of wavelength longer than the visible lights are called as the non-ionizing rays. Microbicidal wavelength of UV rays lie in the range of 200 to 280 nanometer, with 260 nanometer being most effective. UV rays are generated using high pressure mercury vapor lamp. It is at this wavelength that the absorption by the microorganism is at its maximum, which results in the germicidal effect. Since UV rays don't kill spores, they are considered to be of use in surface disinfection. UV rays are employed to disinfect hospital wards, operation theaters, virus laboratories, corridors, etc. The next are ionizing rays. Ionizing rays are of two types, particulate and electromagnetics. Electron beams are particulate in nature. High-speed electrons are produced by linear accelerator from an heated cathode. Electron beams are employed to sterilize articles like syringes, gloves, dressing packs, foods, and pharmaceuticals. While gamma rays are electromagnetic in nature, which emanate from nuclear disintegration of certain radioactive isotopes, they have more penetrative power than electron beam but require longer time of exposure. These high energy radiations damages the nucleic acid of the microorganism. The next method of sterilization is filtration, or we can call it as a mechanical method, in which we filter out the substance. Filtration does not kill microbes, it only separates them out. Membrane filters with pore size between 0.2 to 0.45 micrometer are commonly used to remove particles from solutions that can be autoclaved. It is used to remove microbes from heat labile liquid such as serum, antibiotic solutions, sugar solutions, urea solutions. Filtration is aided by using either positive or negative pressure using vacuum pumps. So in filtration, we do not kill the microorganism, we just make separate it from the solution. The first aid we use for filtration is earthenware filters. These filters are made up of diatomaceous earth or porcelain. They are usually baked into the shape of candle. The types of earthenware filters are pasture chamberlain filter. These candle filters are made up of porcelain, that is sand and kaolin. These filters are made with various porosities, which are graded as L1, L1A, L2, L3, L5, L7, L9 and L11. Dalton filters are again graded as P2, P5 and P11. The second class of earthenware filter is Birkfeld filter. These are made up of Kieselguhr. They are available in three grades depending on their porosities, that is V, N and W. Quality of V grade filter is checked using culture suspension of Sertia marcescens having a size 0.75 micrometer. Then the third class of earthenware filter is Mandler filter. These filters is made up of Kieselguhr, asbestos and plaster of Paris. So this is about the earthenware filters. Then next is asbestos filters. These filters are made up of chrysotile types of asbestos, chemically composed of magnesium silicate. They are pressed to form discs, which are to be used only once. The disc is held inside a metal mount, which is sterilized by autoclaving. They are available in following grades: HP-PYR for removal of pyrogens, HPEKS for absolute sterility and HPEK for clarifying. So these are the grades of asbestos filters with their use, specific use. Then the next are sintern glass filters. These are made up from finely ground glass that are fused sufficiently to make small particles added to each other. They are usually available in the form of disc fused into the glass funnel. Filters of grade 5 have average pore diameter of 1 to 1.5 micrometer. They are washed in running water in reverse direction and cleaned with warm concentrated H2SO4 and sterilized by autoclaving. Then the next are membrane filters. These filters are made from polymeric materials such as cellulose nitrate, cellulose diacetate, polycarbonate and polyester. The older type of membrane filters called as a gradacol, graded collodion membrane was composed of cellulose nitrate, which have pore size or pore diameter of 3 to 10 micrometer. But nowadays the newer ones are composed of cellulose diacetate. These membranes have a pore diameter ranging from 0.015 micrometer to 12 micrometer. These filters are sterilized by autoclaving. Membrane filters are made in two ways. The capillary pore membrane have pore produced by radiation, while the labyrinthine pore membrane are produced by forced evaporation of solvents from cellulose esters. So this is about the membrane filters and the filtration process for the sterilizer. Then the next are chemical methods, in which the first is gaseous sterilization, destruction of living microorganisms with a chemical in a gaseous or vapor state. Material which are adversely affected by dry and moist heat sterilization are sterilized by using this method. There are some materials which are affected badly or harmfully when we sterilize them by using dry heat or moist heat, or they get degrade. To avoid the degradation effect or harmful effect after sterilization on such materials, the gaseous methods of sterilization are used. All these gases are toxic to human beings above certain concentration and may exhibit undesirable side effect. Ethylene oxide, formaldehyde, beta propiolactone are used as a gaseous sterilizing agents in pharmaceuticals and medical fields, while glycols, methyl bromides and alcohols are used for room sterilization. So these are the chemicals or chemical gases we use for the sterilization. Let's see one by one. The first chemical is formaldehyde. This gas is generated by heating concentrated solution of formaldehyde. Formaldehyde is an aqueous solution, is known as formalin, and contains 37 to 40% formaldehyde. Formaldehyde gas is generated by adding 150 gram of KMnO4 to 280 ml of formalin for 1000 cubic foot of room volume. After the start of generation of formaldehyde gas, the doors should be sealed and left unopened for 48 hours for good sterilization effect. Formaldehyde combines with protein and nucleic acid and kills both vegetative cells as well as spores. Formaldehyde is a gas form can be used as a disinfectant and sterilization purpose of enclosed areas. Then the next chemical is beta propiolactone, that is BPL. It is a colorless liquid at a room temperature having high boiling point, that is 155 degrees Celsius. It is capable of killing all microorganisms and very active against viruses. BPL vapors as a disinfectant are 25 times more active than formaldehyde, 4000 times more active than ethylene oxide, and about 50,000 times more active than methyl bromide. So this is the strength of BPL vapor. It is highly bactericidal and used in concentration of 2 to 5 mg per liter. It shows irritation and carcinogenic effect. Hence, it is not recommended for use in pharmaceutical applications. The next chemical is ethylene oxide. It is a colorless liquid having boiling point 10.8 degrees Celsius. Hence, it is highly inflammable and may be explosive when mixed with air in concentration greater than 3%. Action of ethylene oxide is due to its power of alkylating the amino, carboxyl, hydroxyl and sulfhydryl groups in the enzyme and protein molecules. It reacts with DNA and RNA. It is powerful sterilizing agent for heat and moisture sensitive materials. It can be used for biological and medical preparations. Then the next chemical method is by using disinfectant. Chemicals agent most commonly used as a disinfectants are phenol, alcohols. The phenols and its derivatives are obtained by distillation of coal tar and have a powerful microbicidal activity. And the example of phenol and its derivative which we can use as a disinfectant are phenol, cresol, meta and para ortho. all three forms of cresol we can use as a disinfectant, then chlorocresol, etc. Then the alcohols have rapid bactericidal action against vegetative bacteria when diluted to concentration about 60-70% volume by volume with water. Ethanol in concentration 60-70% and isopropanol in concentration 50-60% used as a skin disinfectant, while methanol vapor used as a fungicide, propyl butyl amyl are more germicidal than ethanol. About sterilization, we see the different terms related with the sterilization and the different methods which we use for the sterilization to kill the microorganisms. If you have any questions, please raise your question in comment section, and thank you for watching the video.